Let's pray. Father, we love you. We're glad that we can sing, Lord, that you arose. And so, Lord, I pray this morning that you would meet with us. There's no question. There's no doubt that, Father, we're a needy people. And, God, in this room this morning, there's a lot of needs. And, Father, I'm always encouraged and amazed how you can take one message. And, God, you can speak to all of us. And so, Father, I pray this morning, God, that you'd speak to all of us. Lord, we love you. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for paying our sin debt so we could have forgiveness and go to heaven. So I pray you'd meet with us today. We'll thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.
Power.
What a great song. We're always delighted to have visitors. I know we have several that are visiting with us this morning. Sister Akash, why don't you stand and tell us who you have with you this morning. Wonderful. It's good to have some of her family with us today. Any of our members, you got some family members, we'd love to meet them. If you're not, I don't want to put you on the spot. I'll put her on the spot, all right? And anybody else would like to do that? Anybody else? Okay, I know we got visitors. Would you raise your hand if you're a visitor this morning, first time? Wonderful. Good to have a lot of visitors with us today. Welcome to visitors this morning. Good to see Miss Christina. I know she's in the crowd. Where are you at, Miss Christina? Right there. Why don't you stand? We want to see you, okay? You stand. There's Miss Christina. Brother Morris is on vacation. She's brought the children with her, and he's back taking it easy, all right? And it's good to see Brother Robert and Miss B this morning. Welcome them this morning. These are very faithful members, but because of Miss B's health, they hadn't been able to come for months. And we're glad that they were able to be with us here this morning. And I'm going to get in trouble for this one. But Brother Jay, why don't you stand? I want y'all to see Brother Jay. And Brother Jay got Trucker of the Year. Unbelievable. Amen. You can be seated. And I had a lot of people come up to me and mention that. That is a tremendous accomplishment that he's had there. And I know the family is proud of him. And Brother Peterson, why don't you come and get right here? Okay, I'm going to have you come here in a minute. And our missionaries to Uganda, and they've been there for 24 years. We've been supporting the Petersons for 26 years. And they are doing a tremendous job in Uganda. You know, I know you hear me say this a lot, but boy, if you miss Sunday school, he did a tremendous, tremendous job. He's going to come in a minute and say a word to all of us. Well, we'll not have choir practice tonight. Is that right? No choir practice. And then, but we will have prayer at 5:30. Church begins at 6 o'clock. And then April 5th and the 6th, Men's for Christ. If you need a ride, now you don't need to sign the sheet that we have on the Welcome Center, only if you need a ride. We have a van. We can take a bus. And this is in Walker Springs, Jackson, Alabama. And we'll be hosting it here at our church next year. And but this is April 5th and 6th. All of our men, teenagers, young men are welcome to go. It's free. And they'll do a great job. Some really great speakers are lined up. And then our Deep South Youth Conference yard sale. All of this goes for our teenagers toward the youth conference. That'll be April the 13th. You can see my wife, Sister Rebecca, or Miss Mary Jean about that. April the 19th is our all-night prayer meeting. And it's not really a wrong or right way to do that, but from 10 to 5 in the morning, we'll be praying, and we really need to be praying. And if you want to sign up for a particular time on that, you could do that. If you want to pray all night, that is fine as well. But that'll be Friday night, April the 19th, and looking very much forward to that. Okay, Brother Johnson's going to come and say a little word about the lilies.
We're so thankful that you participated and helped us with the Easter lilies this year. And we will do this again next year. We'll be looking forward to that. But at the end of the service, you'll be able to come down and to, if you bring your ticket, you can come to either side. We'll have workers, helpers on this side and on this side. If you have your ticket, you could just bring your ticket, give it to them, and they'll give you the Easter lily. If you forgot your ticket, that is okay. We have a list. Brother Brian and Miss Lamb will be down front in the middle, and you can just simply come and see them, and they will make sure that you get your Easter lily. Thank you so much for helping us with this year, and we're so thankful that we were able to do it.
There will be grace and
Amen. Let's stand together and grab your songbook. 150, He Lives. We're going to sing 150, He Lives, and we'll turn right over and sing Because He Lives. Amen. Let's sing 150, hymn 150, He Lives. I serve a risen Savior. Help me now in that first verse.
I serve a risen Savior. He's able.
His Son, because He lives. Y'all help me now.
God sent His Son. Say.
song. So delighted to have the Petersons with us. I wanted you to see Miss Lisa if she was standing out there. You couldn't see her. And you didn't get to hear all that we heard in Sunday school of the sacrifice. And this couple has made. And I know they give all the honor and the glory to God. But, you know, we love and appreciate missionaries. And Uganda, preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. And we'll never know till we get to heaven exactly all that God has done through this couple. But I can tell you some churches has been started and folks has been saved and they're going to go to heaven. And I appreciate this couple. Would you welcome them here this morning? Appreciate them. I know, again, to give the praise and honor to the Lord, but we ought to be very thankful as a church for this couple representing us. And the sacrifice of being away from home and family at very times like today. But I'm glad they could be with us. And they'll be going back in June. And so Brother Peterson's going to come. He's going to say a word, and then he's going to lead us in prayer. We'll have a special, and then we'll have the message this morning.
Thank you, Faith Baptist Church, for living up to your name, living by faith, and being faithful all these years to support us in Uganda. We thank the Lord for the opportunity we've had to represent you there, and thank you for standing behind us in prayer and in faithful support. We appreciate you so much from 26 years ago, taking a chance on us as we were on deputation, and then going to the field in February of 2000, and for the past 24 years of being faithful to be a supporting church. We appreciate that so much. A few things have changed since 5 years ago when we reported back. Our kids are now out of the house and thankfully serving the Lord at our home church there in Oklahoma City. And we are now in the capital city of Kampala, Uganda, continuing to work in a Bible college, training men to go out and start churches and seeing many, many people saved. And so we thank the Lord for that and appreciate you all. Let's go ahead and have a word of prayer. Father, we thank you for your goodness to us this day, for your love, for your care for us, in sending your Son to die on the cross, to be buried, to raise again from the dead, so that we might be justified. We could have eternal life as simply a gift from you to be received. Bless today as that message goes forth of that completed work that Christ has done on our behalf. I pray it would speak to every heart, meet every need, and draw, Lord, those to yourself who have not yet trusted Christ as Savior. I pray today would be a great day, a day of salvation for each one who might not be saved yet. Bless, Lord, in all that's done, the preaching of your word especially. May you be magnified and lifted up. May all of us be drawn closer to you, we pray in Christ's name. Amen.
Stripes of blood that stained his frame, shed to wash away our shame. From the scars, pure love released, salvation by the mercy tree. In the spot between two thieves, our Savior chose.
All right, we appreciate that good singing this morning. If you have your Bibles, the Gospel of John, chapter number 20, the Gospel of John, chapter number 20. I'm going to try to do y'all a favor today. I'm going to try to get you out of here before 1:30. All right, is that fair? Now, you ought to see visitors when you say that, all right? Just messing with you. And John, the Gospel of John, chapter number 20. John, chapter number 20. We need to get right into the message this morning. If you're able, why don't we stand? John, chapter 20. I will read out loud. You can follow in your Bible as I read. John, chapter number 20, and beginning in verse number 19. The Gospel of John, chapter number 20, and look at verse number 19. Then the same day at evening, being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut where the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews, came Jesus and stood in the midst and saith unto them, Peace be unto you. And when he had so said, he showed unto them his hands and his side. I love this right here. Then were the disciples, what does it say? Glad. And then I want to add, I bet they were glad. Amen. Amen. I bet they were. Then were the disciples glad when they saw the Lord. Then said Jesus to them, Again, peace be unto you. As my Father hath sent me, even so sent I you. When he had said this, he breathed on them and saith unto them, Receive ye the Holy Ghost. Whosoever sins ye remit, they are remitted unto them. And whosoever sins ye retain, they are retained. But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore saith unto him, We have seen the Lord. But he saith unto them, Except I shall see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side. Watch this. I, what does it say? Will not believe. And after 8 days, again his disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, Peace be unto you. Then said he to Thomas, Reach hither thy finger, and behold my hands, and reach hither thy hand, and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but what? Believe. But believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, My Lord and my God. And Jesus saith unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast what? Believe. Watch this. Blessed are they that have not seen and what? And yet have believed. And many other signs truly did Jesus in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written that you might what? That you might believe. That Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing, you might have what? Life through his name. Our Father, we love you. We thank you for your word, the good singing we've heard, and how our hearts have been ministered. But God, we're needy people. And God, within this room today, there's a lot of needs. And so I would pray in these next few moments, you'd help us to, on purpose, to be still, on purpose, to pay attention. And God, that we would hear what you have to say to the church today. We love you. Thank you for the great price, Lord, that was paid for our sins. And Lord, I pray now you'd help us, and we'll thank you for it. In Jesus' name, we do pray and ask it all. Amen. You may be seated. I really appreciate your patience there. I'm just going to quickly back up and show you what Thomas said. Jesus had risen again, of course, on the first day of the week, Sunday early, and he appeared to the disciples and said some things to them. And as we read the story, Thomas was not with them. And so the disciples, when Thomas came into their presence, said, the disciples told Thomas, "We've seen the Lord." And then Thomas says, I don't believe that. And as a matter of fact, he went as far as to say, "Except I shall see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side." And he said, "I will not believe." And so we see here that Thomas, hearing from the disciples that Jesus had risen, said to them, "I do not believe you. I do not believe this." And so from those thoughts this morning, when Thomas said, "I will not believe," he didn't say, "I could not believe." He said, "I will not believe." Just very briefly, I want to preach on why I believe that Jesus Christ rose again, or why I believe in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And if I were to ask you to come up and you were going to give the message this morning, and we just kind of had you come, you know, file one by one, and I want you to give some reasons why do you believe in the resurrection of Jesus? And many of you do. Let's just quickly just take a little survey and just see quickly this morning. How many of you believe that Jesus Christ rose again the third day and that he is alive right now? Would you raise your hand, okay? You put your hands down, and that was the majority of you. And I figured that most of you would testify that you believe in the resurrection. But if I were to ask you, why do you believe?